Why shouldn't I charge me, myself, and I? Myself and I. Play the odds, a yes man, it's just a bobblehead doll. Holler them all. Strutting like Pac out the court. Hop out the Porsche. Shake that, got that on menu, the a la carte. Boy, I had to make my point about this wave. Watch for the sharks bounce. Sharks bounce. I gave it up and talking Cuban links. Tell her ain't no weak link in my Cuban link. Only like my age. We was ganging since the platinum FUBU days. I got dreams of being Hova, Achi, Movie, yay. Listen, babe, listen good, you'll think I'm cool with yay. Okay, my diamonds dancing, I can f*** Lisa Ray. Life is hard, but it's easy being truthful, baby. Overload, this is like I got like my pinky, my pinky, money, baby, we don't baby, it ain't us, bet it back, I bet I match it like the same style, chopsticks for beef, I'm shutting PF Chang's down, I gave you prophecy, my first one, then you lamed out, luckily, sold, but it wasn't for me, still the flow raw, peep the way I bubble in these streets, who can f*** with me?
Nikki, baby.
Go.
Thank you, Coach. From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their Dolphins emerging from the Hard Rock Stadium tunnels, and we're ready to go as the Dolphins get set to match up with Marcus Mariota and the Tennessee Titans. No more training camp, no more exhibitions. The 2018 NFL season on EA Sports is underway. Jakeem Grant now to return. Room here to run. There he goes, left side. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. as his guys are in for six. And the Dolphins are going to take a first quarter lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Down throw for Mariota. Goes underneath for Henry. And they're able to get this one across the 35. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. He just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Second down throw for Mariota. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Bobby McCain. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will score. Touchdown, Miami. That's a tough spot as a quarterback, Charles. You want to get rid of it, but you see what can happen when you do try to get rid of it with pressure.
Yeah, and how about the pressure coming without them having to blitz? That's when you know things are clicking for your defense, and the end result, they end up gaining 6 points.
And again, it's no good. A few boo birds coming out as he's missed his second extra point here in the first half. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Back to it after the pick six. Mariota, Stocker's got it, complete. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
On second down, here's Henry. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. These two teams, Titans and Dolphins, met last year, week 5. That was Jay Cutler versus Matt Castle, and it was the Dolphins getting a fourth quarter touchdown from Jarvis Landry, and they held on to win 16-10 in South Florida. They keep it with Henry on first down, and he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Mariota now on second down. He finds Taylor complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Let's go.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry. Finds a seam inside the 40. And finally down at the 32-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter. And a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 32-yard line. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Cross the 30 down to the 29-yard line. Give him 3 on the keeper there, and it is second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll try to throw now. Mariota sets up the screen to Lewis. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Give him 5 on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. From the gun, Mariota. And he's got a man, Corey Davis. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4 for 4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row. I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
Forced hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So a first quarter fumble in the rain, and this isn't supposed to let up. They've had flash flood warnings just west of here, so they better get used to this.
And it's hard to do real early in the game because You're so amped up, and you're trying to do so much. You've got to get used to it, though. You've got to focus in on the ball. Make sure you're taking care of it. That one cost him.
A first carry for Kenyon Drake. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run. All right, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. 3rd and long coming up, back near your own goal line. I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for them. You got to try and find some space for your punter because you don't want him backed up where he has to alter what he does.
And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. First down, Drake, and he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
And the ball moved up here now to 2nd and 7 following the penalty. They'll run here with Balazs. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Tackle made there by Jonathan Cyprian.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play.
Clay! Good! Hey, 20! Go!
From the gun on 3rd down, Tannehill. And he has a goal over the catch. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really good pickup of 28 yards. So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 47. Tannehill hands to Drake. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 13. From the 50, it's Tannehill. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Third and long, it's Tannehill. Trying to lay one up deep. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And now running right through it. And the young buck, the rookie, just racked up his first career interception.
And how about the scouting department? They've got to be very happy right now because In NFL parlance, he's a third-day selection. Anyone after the fourth round? That's big-time scouting right there, and what a great play he just made.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. The start of the round, it's Derrick Henry. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Second down, Mariota. That's brought in by Davis over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
On first and 10, here's Mariota. Buying time to his left. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really of how he can hurt you. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Miami after this. To Henry. Here's Mariota on the move to his left. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down. He'd had some success as a runner previously on this drive, just not as much space there that time.
Yeah, this time when he pulled it down, they were ready for him, so I think he's going to have to fling a few in order to open up that running lane again.
Inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
We used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. He's going to get it running right. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Call it a gain of a couple. The defense stiffening here. It's third and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here. Brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And Succop will put this one right through, and the drive will wind up yielding three. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
This offense trots back out there now, and as they do, Charles, one thing to point out that we saw a second ago are some of the new rules in the NFL this year regarding kickoffs.
Yeah, nowadays, the kickoff team, no more running starts. Remember that when you got to circle a guy around and here he goes? No more. You have to start, you know, close to the ball, and when it's kicked, then you get to take off and go, so you can't build up your speed that way. Also, when you're returning it, remember those wedges that we used to say where guys would form together, two or three guys? No more of those, so it'd be a lot more man on.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. You think you're going into halftime with a good-sized lead? Not so fast. That pick six really changes the complexion, probably also changes the halftime speech.
No doubt about it. Instead of going in relaxed, you're probably a little more uptight right now, probably a little bit angry. Let's see if they can get their focus back.
Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And that will get them one closer. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Here comes Grant on the return. And there he goes again. The 40. Past the 20. And he takes it the distance. No time remaining.
No cloth on the field.
Yeah, no flags. And it's a kickoff return to end the first half.
Again, help me, partner. I've got to get fired up. Two kickoff returns for touchdowns in the same game. This is fun to watch.
Yeah, we call a lot of games at a lot of different places. Sometimes it seems like we do it simultaneously, but we rarely get to see this. Third time's a charm on the extra point as he gets this one to go. So we've reached halftime here on All right, we will save the week one highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And the Titans getting set to go. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Second half begins with a run by Henry, and not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of three, second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. Working out of the gun, Mariota. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Coverage that time by Bobby McCain.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
They have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe. The Titans on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 7. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. And that's caught by Smith. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What did the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
First down, Mariota. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Call it a gain of three, and that'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
They'll throw again, Mariota. Over the middle, complete. It's Davis. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Now that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play, that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Now it's a bootleg with Mariota. He'll buy some time right. And he's got room! And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. He turned that into a nice game. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
The best quarterbacks that ever played the game all wanted to blend in with their teammates and be one of the guys. But sometimes you got to take modesty and put it aside. You're the franchise quarterback, the face of the team, and the guy that leads them to victory. You have to get down and protect yourself and not take hits like that.
Third and long here for Mariota. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. Oh, and now some space tackling. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Yo, trip left, trip left.
On second down, it's Drake. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be third down. Third down, Tannehill. It's caught. Stills, right side. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down. Now the old pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now, with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take care of the ball in open field, sometimes the fighting for extra yardage doesn't come as a result. That and good tackling could lead to no yards gained.
I tell you, it's not easy kicking field goals in the best of conditions. Yet in a downpour like we're in right now, it makes it that much harder. And sure enough, they can't convert here.
Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it'll be a second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Mariota now from the 50. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Davis. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Mariota now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. A first down carry for Henry. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about 3 down to the 38.
Tough first half for him. Unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. Wide open receiver complete. The Titans efficient passing on this drive. There's another first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Mariota now 12 of 17 through the air as he leads his guys up on first down. From the red zone now, Mariota. Now they go screen, it's complete. No gain on the screen there, it's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Mariota now. His throw caught right around the 6. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. He's up to 70 yards receiving now as that last catch gets him a first down. So they've been in the red zone 3 times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? They'll run for Deion Lewis. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Second and goal from the 6 this time. Mariota now on second down. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
Brandon, I don't want to violate any of our broadcasting rules by declaring a game over before it's over. But that one, that puts them in real jeopardy there.
Absolutely. It was a two-possession game. It is a two-possession game at this stage in the fourth. They needed points out of that drive.
And obviously now, no chance at all to get those points that they so desperately needed.
Tannehill and the Dolphins break the huddle. Come up first and 10 at their own 24. Following the fumble recovery, Tannehill. And Escobar has it left side. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. A gain of 6 there on first.
Sometime in this fourth quarter, someone on defense is going to have to step up and force a turnover.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Play, play. Check.
Now on first down, Drake again. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And some room to work. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. It'll be a gain of 7, and they get it back to a 3rd and 3.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Hey, 20.
On 3rd and short, Drake. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Yeah, the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Here's Matt Hawk now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And so close to hitting pay dirt last time, fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players, too, who thought, hey, we're going to put some points up and have a little momentum going. They've got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go.
Short-term memory.
And move on to the next series.
Mariota now to throw on 1st down. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Bobby McCain. And he will score. Touchdown, Miami.
Now that was a beautiful play. A pick 6. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What do you mean, with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
Sanders on for the extra point. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. Adoree Jackson on the return. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense.
I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10, just shy of the 30. Back to it after the pick six. Mariota. Stocker's got it. Complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. Decent start there to the drive. Big hill to climb, needing two touchdowns, also a 2-point conversion.
So, partner, how do you eat an elephant?
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the linebacker, Raekwon McMillan.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Tannehill now running the option to the right side and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 6 yards there on the keeper. It's second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Tannehill now running the option to the right side. And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off at the 40. He's at the 40. The 20. 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. You just got through saying a moment ago someone was going to need to step up and force a turnover. Not only a turnover, but 6 points.
Yeah, think about it from the defense's perspective. How do you take the ball away, and can you convert it into points? Didn't even have to rely on their offense. They did it all on their own.
And now this defense, they'll be coming right back on the field and still more work to do trailing. All right, now a big 2-point conversion attempt still to come. The interception here, Mariota, and this is going to be caught. And how about that? Even after snapping it from back there, they still convert for the 2 points. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. The return man is Grant. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it first and 10.
There you go.
They'll start the drive with Drake. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They run it with Balazs. Taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
30! 20!
Drake off the give from Tannehill. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Right back to Drake. There he goes inside the 30 and down to the 28-yard line. And partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week one. You had the flyover, the big American flag out there before the game, all the hoopla, just having football back, so special.
It is an opening day.